I'm the manager of the planetarium is one of my roles. That's about 20% of what I do here at the planetarium or at SCOE. I also do a lot of other work with STEM education. I'm the science coordinator. And so I have multiple hats that I wear. So in terms of the planetarium, I'm in the management role. I don't run the equipment. I don't do the shows. But I manage the two part-time people that we have that do the shows. And then I have an administrative assistant who works under me as well in terms of handling various details of the planetarium.
And when you say SCOE, that stands for the Shasta County Office of Education.
Correct. Sorry. We're buried in acronyms in education.
Well, I'd like to clarify. Well, also then that means that is who owns and controls the planetarium. What is sort of the, who is this a nonprofit? Is it a for-profit? Who owns and controls it, and how does all that work?
So Shasta County Office of Education, every county has an Office of Education, and answers to the state then. So as a public entity. And it's actually very unusual to have a planetarium that is run by a county office of education. It is a wonderful thing that we offer and unique. Usually they're more part of a museum or a bigger Turtle Bay sort of place. They often have that kind of thing. So we're very fortunate to have it. And we all know that. We all like and appreciate the value of the planetarium.
So just to be entirely thorough, I like to assume that viewers don't necessarily have any sort of knowledge. Explain what a planetarium is to a layperson.
Right. And there is some, I heard some confusion on that. I've seen that on the Facebook pages too, and we have a Facebook page for Schreder Planetarium. Schreder Planetarium also has schrederplanetarium.com where you can go for more information. So a planetarium is a place where you have a dome and you project images on it. It's a movie theater with a round ceiling, and that offers a lot of opportunities to feel like you're truly outside. It is not an observatory. I heard someone talking about an observatory, and that is when you go to see the stars and you can see the stars through a telescope. And we don't have a telescope in this building. This is for projection.
We do have a sort of a fairly well-known observatory nearby at Hat Creek, don't we? Is that related to the planetarium? Is there any kind of maybe I'm just throwing that out there for a future thing? But to stick with the topic today, we just came down from the Shasta County Office of Education board meeting, and there was a lot of people from the public there who were concerned about the possible closing of the planetarium. So what can you tell me about the history of the planetarium leading up to this point in time and where it stands now?
Well, I'm not an expert on the history of the planetarium. I've just started working for Shasta County Office of Ed 18 months ago, and they handed me the planetarium, 7 or 8 months ago. So I know as much as you would find on the website, and I would refer you there for details. But essentially, 1979, this was constructed. Wonderful gem. We've had some upgrades since then, and we haven't had an upgrade in almost 10 years in terms of the hardware that we use. And that's one of the concerns now, the current history, is the hardware that we're looking at is this. Actually, a lot of this isn't in use. This is even older. But what we do have is it's outdated. And when you come to see a show, it's a good show, and people enjoy the shows. But it's not the quality that we'd really like to have. So that's one of the issues that we're dealing with right now at the planetarium, and definitely not the most important one. Most important one we've talked about many times is the lack of student attendance to the planetarium. 1% of the county students see a show in the planetarium in a typical year.
So do you have a theory as to why that is or what could be done about it? I mean, if it's owned by the Office of Education, you would think there should be some sort of channel of communication to the students or to the teachers.
Absolutely, and there is. Well, first of all, we can on one hand say it's a landmark and everybody loves it and everybody knows about it, and on the other hand say nobody knows about it, why aren't they showing up? It has to be one way or the other.
Right.
And what we do is we send out communications to the principals throughout the county every year in the fall, or summer now with the way school starts, so August. And then throughout the year, if I'm sending science information, I usually include information about the planetarium with that as well. So there's certainly, I would say, the vast majority are quite aware that the planetarium exists. We did a survey to ask why people like the planetarium and why they don't show up. And we surveyed a nice cross-section of teachers. And, the answers were really mixed. There were a lot of different answers to that. There were thoughts that the price was too high, which is hard when we're not already charging enough to balance the budget. There were thoughts that it's outmoded, but that was pretty minor. a lot of thoughts about field trips are just very expensive. You have to pay for your bus service, regardless of what we charge. You pay for that bus service. So that seems to be one of the problems. And some schools then will limit the number of trips that their students can go on. You know, you can do 3 a year. So given a choice of 3, the planetarium is a viable option, but there are other options as well. So there's a level of competition there too.
So a lot of it has to do, you think, with the amount of budget the schools themselves can allocate to field trips. They can only have so many field trips. They can't go as many places. That stands to reason. My viewers that are concerned and want to do something, because I heard at the meeting that the way that it's modeled, that more people showing up to the public shows costs the planetarium more money. Is that the case? So people showing up to shows isn't necessarily going to help? Am I wrong?
You're right. And the way I like to say it is more shows cost more money. If every show we charge $7, and in order to break even, we needed to charge, depending on what break even means to you, if we're looking at replacing hardware or just operating expenses, you know, we would need to charge either $17 or $28, depending on which of those goals we're going towards. So every time we're open, we lose money. So every show loses money. More shows is more loss. Now, if we could keep the same number of shows and fill the room, yeah, I understand that. There's a certain amount of profit to be made there that would be helpful. But the trouble is, to really service more students or more people in the public means more shows, means more loss.
So you're not necessarily turning people away at the door for these shows, or what is your attendance like?
You know, it really varies. We just had a nice show because of all of the recent publicity we've had. There's a lot of people saying, well, I'm going to show up and help the planetarium. So we had about 60 people here recently, but I would say more typical numbers are around 30. And we've had shows that are more near 20, sometimes 40, but yeah, 30 maybe is a decent average for that.
So if you could fill the house or nearly fill the house every time, then you wouldn't necessarily lose money on the public shows. Maybe I'm veering into speculation here, but because I sort of want to know, do I want to encourage people to come or not? And
right.
I guess then that leads to the question, all these people who are concerned, right, what should they do or can they do to help the planetarium?
So, yeah, on that greater question, I guess one is, sure, it's great to come to shows because we've already got them on the calendar. You can go to our website. You can come to a show. We'd love to fill every seat. That's helpful. I haven't done the math to see. That's actually a really interesting question. Would we still lose money if we filled every seat? And I think the answer is yes, even when you fill every seat. But it's better to have 64 than to have 30 if you're going to have the same expenses. So, yeah, come to a show by all means. If you go to the SchraderPlanetarium.com site, there is a way to donate money as well through a foundation, because the County Office of Education can't do that ourselves. But there is a foundation, and that could lead to something like maybe purchasing the hardware. So we could upgrade the hardware, and that would be beneficial then.
And, of course, there is a gift shop on the way into the planetarium. That's got to add a little bit of something to the bottom line there, too.
A little bit, but remember who our major clientele are. We want to serve students, and we're not in the profit-making business. So, yeah, we make sure we set the prices so we don't lose money on the gift shop, but we don't make money on the gift shop either. I mean, that's not what it's there for. If we had a foundation running that or something else, it might be different. I know some organizations have done that. But the way it works right now, we don't make money on the gift shop either.
So there might be some way of structuring that in some legal way where you wouldn't be, because I imagine that nonprofit and public entities are constrained in all kinds of different legal ways in terms of making a profit. Nathan Fairchild, director of the Planetarium, is there anything that you feel is important that perhaps I have forgotten to ask?
You know, I think what this is all about, to my way of thinking, is about people that want to do the right thing for the planetarium. They recognize it's one of a kind. They want to take care of it. So get involved. You know, find out what's going on. Get on the website. See what's going on there. Go to the Facebook page. Come to board meetings, especially those spring board meetings when they're starting to do budget considerations. Because just like with any government entity, it always comes down to the budget. And when the budget is decided on, that tells you what programs have been funded. So attend those. Get involved. And, you know, hearing that involvement makes a difference for the planetarium, and especially get the schools to come or come back. You know, the recession just hit, and we're leaving that recession behind, but we've got people then who have not come back to any of their field trips. So as parents can encourage that. Say you want that field trip, say you want those field trips to the planetarium, and then really come and discover for yourself what it is. You know, is this the value you want? Because we are in the service of the people. We are in the service of the students. Is this what we should be spending money on? If we spend $1 million over 10 years, is this what we should be spending it on in terms of student education? And we don't, you know, we're exploring that answer right now. So the public can weigh in on that. That'd be really helpful.
Nathan Fairchild, thank you very much for talking to the Phantom Penguin.
All right. Thank you.